Well, our next guest is teaching our Pollies a thing or two about the art of influence, but not before helping Scott Morrison out with a little performance review.
Prime Minister, nice to see you. Welcome. Please take a seat. We've asked your colleagues to submit some feedback on you, which they've kindly submitted via text message. So let's have a look at what they've got to say about you. First one there, fraud. Okay. Complete psycho. Right? And horrible, horrible person. Huh? And these are the good ones.
Please welcome Mark Humphries.
Don't freak out. You're on TV. I kind of forgot how it works.
It's been a while.
Mark, great to have you here.
It is, isn't it?
It is great. On such a momentous day.
Oh.
And I'm sure Scott Morrison is very grateful for all of that very helpful feedback. Mm. But in the interests of fairness, have you got any of that helpful feedback for Albo?
Fairness? I thought this was a commercial network. Well, I mean, in fairness, like, all of that feedback was from Morrison's own colleagues. So those are not my words. So if Albo's colleagues have things to say about him, then I'm happy to repeat them. But for the moment, they've, kept storm. And the best I can give you is, I think, Tony Windsor, former independent MP Tony Windsor, once described Albanese as a meerkat. Complete psycho or meerkat, the vote is yours.
Does that mean he warms himself in the morning by getting his belly out?
I think it's just if the election doesn't pan out, he wants to get that compare the market money.
Hakuna
Matata. Yeah.
That is a sick burn. Well, happy election announcement day.
Thank you.
Were you as shocked as we all were to find out that this was going to be on May 21st?
Was I shocked that Morrison left it to the last possible minute? Very unlike him. Yes. No, it was great that he finally found a job that he couldn't say was a matter for the states.
do you find, as a comic, that it's one of those things people go, oh, well, you must love this, the election, plenty of material.
Yes.
Does it work that way for you?
Well, elections are like, they're like Christmas for satirists. So I particularly love tracking the disendorsements. That's it. So the people who, you know, once journos start digging around, they find, you know, the candidate who posted photos of themselves groping the wax figures at Madame Tussauds, those sorts of things. You know, the election was called today. The United Australia Party already has four candidates that have been disendorsed or resigned. That's what we call today.
That's a lot of wax figures. I have a wax figure at Madame Tussauds. If anyone wants to have a crack at it.
May I?
Yes, this is it now.
You've got a new comedy show. It's called Spin. And you're going to shine a light on some of the tactics that perhaps we're going to see during the election campaign.
That's it.
What are they?
Well, you know, the usuals, you know, distracting from a lack of policy ideas by, you know, cooking a masaman curry, you know, that sort of basic sort of thing. You know, pretending you've answered a question by just avoiding it entirely. I'm looking forward to sort of some of those moments, like in 2013 when Tony Abbott... there's a lot of candidates to remember the names of, you know, and in 2013 he couldn't remember the name of his candidate in the seat of Denison, and her name was Tanya Denison. For that sort of stuff.
Is that when you just panicked and ate an onion?
Yeah, exactly.
Change the narrative.
Yeah.
Now, you're a bit of a quiz master.
Well, yes. I mean, I don't like to bring up my cancelled quiz show pointless. But if anyone was interested in renewing it, you know, I still have my old quiz ability. So would you like to do a quiz?
Bring us up to speed.
Here, you know what? I love cue cards. You don't see them enough on TV.
Can I get a microphone with a long cable? Okay, all right. Well, I'll start with you, Rove.
Please
do. We'll go around the term. So, question one. Scott Morrison's family are best known as what? Oh. Is it A, Jenny and the Girls, B, Lenny and the Girls, C, Denny and the Girls, or D, Benny and the Jets?
Wow. Look, all of them sound like great backup groups for a man strumming on a ukulele. But I'm going to say A, Jenny.
It is Jenny and the Girls.
How did he do it? I had an onion sitting down here just in case.
The wax sculptor is sweating. Question two. Here's one about Gladys Berejiklian.
Okay.
So if you were the Premier of New South Wales, one of the most powerful women in the country, and you had your pick of any man you wanted... any man. Would you go out with A, Chris Hemsworth, B, Liam Hemsworth, C, Luke Hemsworth, or D, someone named Daryl?
I feel like I should not say that. Obviously, Daryl.
Lisa, question three. In the lead up to the COP26 climate conference, Prime Minister Scott Morrison referred to something as the Australian way. What is the Australian way? Is it A, drinking beer out of a shoe? B, losing the cricket captaincy over a sext? C, a completely ineffective approach to the issue of climate change, which is, frankly, an embarrassment to present to an international conference where every other country has committed to more ambitious targets for the collective well-being of the entire effing planet. Or D, a no-hands piss.
Or E, all of the above.
I think we're out of time for the quiz.
You haven't forgotten it. You know how this works.
Tickets with Mark Spinner on sale right now. All the details are on our website. Mark Humphries, thank you so much. Yeah.